S.R. Balasubramoniyan.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, sir. I thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak on insolvency and bankruptcy code, second amendment bill. In effect, this bill replaces the ordinance promulgated by the government on 6th June 2018. The finance minister had said that in order to fine-tune the insolvency and bankruptcy code, an insolvency law committee was set up by the government to suggest amendments to the IBC. Based on the recommendations of the ILC, this bill has been brought in Parliament. It seems to me that this government has a liking for issuing ordinances. The IBC First Amendment Bill 2018 also essentially replaced the ordinance promulgated by the government on 23rd November 2017. The government amended the Banking Act Regulation Act on 5th May 2017 by issuing an ordinance authorizing the Reserve Bank to issue directions. Any banking company to initiate insolvency resolution process in respect of a default under the provisions of IBC. It is common knowledge that the ordinance route to legislate is resorted to by the executive to meet certain exigencies. Since the bill under discussion basically gives effect to the recommendations of the insolvency committee, what compelling circumstances forced the government to issue an ordinance when it could have easily waited for the monsoon session, which is hardly a month away? Last month, in one of the resolution cases concluded under IBC, banks have had a huge 83% haircut on the sale of Alok Industries, backed by the Reliance Industries, JM Financial ARC combined for just rupees 5,000 crore. Alok Industries owed its creditors an amount of rupees 30,000 crores. The resolution plan of Reliance was put to vote before the Committee of Creditors of Alok Industries on June 20th and received the assent of 72% of the Committee of Creditors, total creditors. It is very interesting to note that voting threshold required to pass a resolution was lowered to 66% from 75% on June 6th by issuing the ordinance just 14 days before the date when COC of Alok Industries was scheduled to meet to approve the resolutions plan submitted by the Reliance. This plan to get Alok Industries at throwaway price of rupees 5,000 crore was rejected by the same COC and its meeting held on 13th April, especially in view of the fact that this company has an asset base of rupees 32,000 crores as per the latest available balance sheet. A perception has been built up that the government is working for the benefit of some corporates, that the resolution of Alok Industries was facilitated with the assistance of the government by amending the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code with such alacrity which is rarely seen. Otherwise, very apparent that IBC was amended in such a haste with the objective to allow Reliance to take over Alok Industries, and in the process, the banks took a massive haircut of 83%. I urge upon the government, Honorable Minister, that in the name of NPE, clean up the government should not be seen by promoting chronic capitalism. In my state, Tamil Nadu, there is a practice of having two separate agreements between home buyers and builders for land and apartment, which gives the customer a status of a secured creditor. Maybe the government can take cue from this. In a big relief to MSME sector, a new section 240A has been inserted in the code. The new clause enables the promoter of MSME to bid for his enterprise undergoing corporate insolvency resolution process, provided he is not a willful defaulter and does not attract other disqualifications not related to default. It is good that the government has realized. Yes, I will just sooner than later that MSMEs from the backbone of the Indian economy in terms of employment generation and economic growth. Section 231 of the code has been amended to provide for bar of jurisdiction of civil courts authorities in matters under jurisdiction of the adjudicating authority and the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. IBBI is a regulatory body having regulatory oversight over the insolvency professionals, insolvency professional agencies, insolvency professional entities, and information utilities. IBBA is not a judicial body. It is very strange that the government proposes to put the matters under IBBI beyond the jurisdiction of this court. This is not a tenable proposition and is liable to be struck down by the judiciary. Therefore, I propose the Honorable Minister to seriously consider this clause in the amendment bill. With these observations and clarifications, I support the passage of the bill. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Balasubramoniyan.